It's a little bit off subject, but the same kind of principle. I heard that, and I won't mention his name, but it was a big leader and founder of a huge satanic organization. And he was on his deathbed, and for a Satanist at the time of death, it's a great victory for them, because death is a huge thing that they celebrate. And he was getting ready to die and pass on his powers and that. And on his deathbed, he must have got some revelation or an angelic appearance or something, and he went into shock and he said, "Oh my.
What have I done?
He said, "There's something very wrong. There's something very wrong. There's something very wrong."
Wow.
And his whole life had been spent propagating these satanic beliefs, getting everyone to believe, establishing official organizations for Satanism. And then at the end of his life, he gets this light that comes to him, and everything that he'd built, he realized was wrong.
Sit back and say, "I don't need God. What is God?" But it's very difficult to be an atheist when you're laying on your deathbed, because you begin to think, what if these people are right? See, there'd been one man by the name of Ron Short that has stood between me and the gates of hell. One man that had witnessed to me about the love of Jesus for 5 years before I became ill. One man. And, you know, I would debate him. And I liked him because he did what he said he was going to do. I mean, he was the only one that I saw that professed to be Christian that lived what he said he was going to do. And so I really respected him. I didn't believe what he said, but I respected him. But when I'm laying on my deathbed and knowing that I'm going to die, guess who I thought about? I thought about, what if Ron is right? What if there is a heaven and a hell? And so immediately, the most pressing thought in my mind is, how do I get saved? What is saved? What is saved? How do I get saved? And so I sent them for Ron Short. I wanted him to come down because I wanted him to do every what he had to do. I had no idea. How can a man hanging on a tree in Israel 2,000 years ago, what is that to me? But I knew that he had something that I had to have. And that night, see, I had him go for Ron, but Ron wasn't home. Ron was in Alabama. And so I had him go and send for Ron. And that night was the longest night that I've ever had in my entire life, before, our sins. And that night, is as I would be laying there in bed, as I'm laying there in bed, I would begin to fade away. I would begin to fade away, and as I would fade away, I would begin to go down. Now, it was like darkness. It was like, it was so, so dark. It was like the very darkness just penetrated into your very, very being. And as I left, and I can tell you I left my body, because I remember when I came back into my body. You know, I don't know where I was out of my body. Now, there are people that talk about a light. There are people that talk about floating above. There are people that talk about a feeling of warmth and love. I didn't feel any of that. I felt none of that. I felt untold terror. Untold terror.
Some revelation or an angelic appearance or something. And he went into shock and he said, "Oh my. Oh my, what have I done?" He said, "There's something very wrong. There's something very wrong. There's something very wrong."
Because I knew that if I ever went all the way, if I slipped all the way, I would never get back. Now, in my beings of beings, I knew that. And so I fought all night long. They told me later on, I not only pulled the mattress cover off of the mattress, I pulled the mattress up on me because I had to stay. I had to wait. I had to wait till Ron got there. Whatever he had to do, I had to wait. But I would, again, and then I would leave, and I would be going down like a deep, deep, dark terror. Now, my skin began to get cold. Now, it's not like cold when you walk out into the air. It's like bone chilling cold in my lower extremities, and you can feel the coldness begin to come up the legs. And again, I would begin to leave. Now, and I would be in that darkness, and I'd be in that void. And I remember one time entering back in my body, because when I entered my body, it was like, just like that. I felt my body thud, my physical body thud when I entered back in. Now, believe me, that is the most horrifying, terrifying experience that I've ever encountered. And I fought all night long, and the next morning, somewhere 9:30, 10 o'clock, in came Ron. And Ron came in and he says, "Dr. Whitaker, what do they say is your chances?" I said, "Ron, they tell me I have none." He says, "Now's the time." And I said, "You're right." I mean, I'd cursed him, I'd spit at him, but now was the time, because I had to have whatever he had, because I had a short period of time on Earth, and I didn't know, have any idea when I might make that trip and go all the way.